Hello everyone! This video will be about the steps that you need to take in order to go through your applications process. A lot of people asking where I'm supposed to start, what to do first, what to do next, what to do then. So I want to cover all steps in this way that will help you to go through this process. First step, I would start from the first one, you have to evaluate your diploma. So there are two main companies that evaluate the diploma, it is ECE and WES. I highly recommend you ECE because it is way easier, you don't have to go through apostille. You have for WES you have to put apostille on your documents, and there are like way more requirements, like I think your transcripts have to be sent directly from university. They're like way more strict and it takes more time and effort. ECE is way more easier, and the best part about them that almost all programs prefer ECE, they accept ECE, and not that many programs accept WES. You know, the only one school that comes to my mind that takes only WES is Western University of Health Science in California, Pomona. If you like, if you want to go to this school, you have to do WES. And the other situation, like Loma Linda University, they don't require WES, but it is a little bit easy if you do WES with them, since they require you to send them transcripts directly from your school, but they can accept WES instead of that. So that might be easier for you to apply to Loma Linda. Otherwise, guys, if that's these two schools are out of your list, I would highly recommend you just do ECE. It's easier and you'll save your money and time. I don't know about money. Money-wise, maybe it's the same. I don't know. Sorry about this. So anyway, the next step, once you're done with your ECE, you should get a dent pin. It's pretty easy on official ADA website. You just file some form with your name. They will issue you a dent pin if you haven't already have it. Then you take INBDE. I would suggest to take INBDE before cycle starts, or maybe in the beginning of the cycle, because the results, like it might take like about 2 weeks or even 3 weeks to get the results from INBDE. The next is TOEFL. You have to take TOEFL, and I'm highly recommend you to score at least above 100 or 105 to stay competitive. That's my personal opinion. I know some schools take TOEFL less than 100. You can definitely apply to those schools if you don't have 100. But if you want to apply to multiple schools, you need a score more than 100. Otherwise, just look on the each school preference for the TOEFL score, and as long as they say that they accept like below 100, they will accept you. That will be fine. So for TOEFL, that's a good thing. You can take TOEFL as many times as you want. It's not like INBDE. They are not gonna report all your attempts, and you don't have to send them. You can take TOEFL like 10 times and send only one score, the one that you are satisfied with. That's how it's gonna work. So don't send your TOEFL scores unless you want admission committee to see it. The next thing, once you're done with this, think about what schools you want to apply. That's important because some schools require a particular TOEFL score, as I already mentioned, and some schools require some other things, like example Casper test. They don't mention like as a requirement, if so far it's only mentioned on Colorado University, but there are more other schools, like five schools, and I listed them in some of my videos, I don't remember all of them, that they don't require it, but they prefer it. And obviously, if they prefer it, I would have taken Casper. I'm not gonna talk too much how to prepare, there is like a book, I also mentioned it in my other video, how you can prepare, but remember Casper test, you can take only once per year, I think that's it. So you gotta study before you take it. And maybe you don't need to take it, I didn't take it. I was thinking I'll have to, but I didn't apply to schools where it was preferred. But I think definitely for Temple it's good to take Casper. And there's other schools, I don't remember all of them, that might, they like to see your Casper score. Anyway, the next step would be, again, I would have read the list of schools to which you want to apply as early as possible, and you can watch my video, like this one, how to choose to which schools to apply. And once you choose, I would have go through their individual school requirements. That way you will know if the school prefers Casper test or the school prefers particular TOEFL score. And then some schools prefer, but no one requires, prefer like ADAT test. Or if you want to improve maybe your application, you can take this test. But this is also, remember, I think you can take it only once maybe a year, I'm not sure. But it's not like TOEFL, definitely. You need to be careful, prepare before you take it. Or don't report your results. So I never took it, so probably I'm not a good source to talk about ADAT. The only thing I know that Michigan kind of prefers to see your ADAT score, but there are plenty of people, multiple people, who got into the Michigan and they didn't do ADAT. So that's not like the issue, it's not a requirement. The next thing that you should start doing, you can start doing your application even before March 1st. You can already start filing your application. You won't be able to do some little things, but mostly you can already start filing your application and do it very thoroughly and nicely, like with details. And then you'll just be already ready and you don't have to rush. You don't have to apply it in the beginning of the cycle. There is no need to rush, but it's good to go like steady flow and, you know, like move forward. So I would have started doing that as well. The other thing that you should start doing even before you start the application cycle starts, work on your personal statement, because that's how you communicate. That's your only chance to communicate with the admission committee. So I would work on it like, no, I would not write it like in a week. I would write it like, I would make multiple drafts and work on it very hard. And also think about from whom you're gonna take your recommendations letters, because once the cycle starts, you can already request your recommendation letters. And it's good to know from whom you're gonna take them and kind of speak to this person ahead and explain the situation again, so it will give you more time, because it might take them like, you know, you need to give them time. It might take them a week or two or three to write you a letter and to upload it. It is like a little bit of procedure. So I would respect that time and I would have start preparing them and talking to them as early as you can. The next thing, that once this is all kind of ready or going on, I would have start thinking about supplemental applications. And for supplemental applications, it's mostly about your answer to the personal statements, personal questions. So a lot of schools, like probably half of the schools, have their own questions that they ask you, either it's in application or it's in their separate supplemental application. Like there might be short questions, or there might be you need to write school-specific personal statement. And don't neglect that. That is very important. If the school has school-specific personal statement, most likely the admission committee will start reviewing your application from this personal statement. So I would pay a lot of attention to what you write there. And I'm gonna make a video probably about this too soon. Then what else? Look at the specific requirements of each school that you're applying. So once you chose the list of the school you're applying, I would go on their website and write down all the requirements for the particular school. And this is it, guys. My last advice is don't rush. Like, there is a common myth is that you have to apply early, that somehow gives you more chances. This is so much not true. Like, some schools are on a rolling basis, but it doesn't mean if you apply late they will not review your application. They still will review each and every application, because that's their job. Some schools encourage you to apply early. They even write it on their website. Like, I don't know, I don't remember which school I was reading, like, apply early. But they are writing that not because they're gonna take you if you apply early or you get more chances. They are writing that from their personal perspective, because they don't want to get all applications at the same day and I don't know, and hire extra people to review them. They don't want to be overloaded. They want their load to be gradual. But you don't need to care about that. That's not about the situation. You care about your personal application. Because if you rush through and apply early, you might like mess up your application or put something in the rush wrong or won't mention some information. So don't think about that. Think about yourself. Apply when you're ready. Obviously before the due date, like never apply after due date, I guess, unless you contact the school and they allow you. But don't rush. That's my advice. So also one little thing that I wanted to mention, that remember that some schools open later. I don't think I knew that, or maybe I knew, I didn't think about that, but a lot of schools like open in March and their due date will be June or July. But some schools, if you like didn't get a chance to apply to these schools, or not to all of them, or you was not ready, there will be schools that will apply later in the cycle, will open later in the cycle. Like such schools as Missouri, like University of Missouri in St. Louis, they open like, I don't remember, somewhere in summer. Or University of Mehari, they open somewhere in summer as well. Just open, so that means their due date will be at the end of the year. And as well as the famous Colorado opens somewhere in September, I think. So it's just like a little thing that you need to remember. If you, I don't know, if you didn't apply or didn't get interview or didn't get in, didn't get accepted or something, you still have a chance like during this application cycle with the schools that will open later. I hope you enjoyed the video. You can comment, ask me anything in the comments below. See you soon, guys.